fact, I am going to talk about BSE-SME Exchange, which I have launched around 6 years back. Though BSE is in existence for 144 years, we have created equity culture in the country and almost got 5,600 companies listed on the stock exchange, creating a market capitalization of $1.5 trillion for all these 5,600 companies. So in that culture, to keep that culture, and because the small and medium entrepreneurs are the assets of the country, which we gives a lot of employment to the young population, we have started around 6 years back this SME platform to ensure that small and medium companies can get funds by diluting their equity and get themselves listed in a very cost effective manner. So 6 years back, it was not a very easy job to start this SME exchange, because we have got OTCI platform launched around 7, 8, 10 years back, which has failed miserably. So though there were a lot of apprehension about this SME exchange, most of the people have written it off, still we thought that for the betterment of this country and for the upliftment of the small and medium entrepreneurs, it's very much required that we should launch this SME platform and take it to the next level. So initially there were a lot of hiccups. That is the second thing. Third thing is, because the equity funds has come in your company, your balance sheet remains strong. Because the equity is there, there may be some part of the loan in your company, but ultimately there is not much of the burden on one form of funding, either debt or equity. It's a balanced balance sheet. And because of which, the profitability of the company keeps on increasing. That is the third. Number fourth, the visibility of the company increases manifold. You don't have to spend a lot of money on your marketing activity. Everybody starts seeing your company, everybody starts knowing your company. Sixth point, the credibility of the company increases manifold. आप ब्रांड बिल्डिंग की बात अभी सुन रहे थे, आप विश्वसनीयता की बात सुन रहे थे कि कैसे कोई व्यक्ति आपकी कंपनी में विश्वास करे. तो जो कंपनी लिस्ट हो जाती है उसको पैसे नहीं खर्चा करने पड़ते हैं अपनी ब्रांड बिल्डिंग के लिए. हम बात करते हैं कि अगर हमको किसी कंपनी की को टेक ओवर करना हो, सो मेनी ऑफ द टाइम्स यू कैन डाइल्यूट योर इक्विटी एंड रेज फंड्स एंड टेक ओवर अदर कंपनी. That is the other way of using the equity that is in your hand post-listing. जो बहुत बड़ी important बात है वो ये है कि आपकी company, अगर आप मान लो 100 करोड़ का धंधा कर रहे हो और 5 करोड़ की profit company में कर रहे हो, तो वो आप कर रहे हो, उसकी value company की कुछ नहीं है. आपने 100 करोड़ की turnover कर ली, business कर ली, 5 करोड़ की profit कमा ली, लेकिन उसकी value क्या है company की? जब आप stock market में आपकी company listing होती है, तो 5 करोड़ की प्रॉफिट के सामने आपकी कंपनी की वैल्यूएशन भी 100 करोड़ की होती है. तो 100 करोड़ की तो टर्नओवर है, 5 करोड़ की प्रॉफिट है, लेकिन जो आज तक कंपनी की कोई वैल्यू नहीं थी, उसकी आज वैल्यू जो है अनलॉक होकर के आती है और आपकी कंपनी की वैल्यू हो गई 100 करोड़. अगर आपने 10% इक्विटी भी किसी को दे दिया, तो आपने 10 करोड़ रुपये कंपनी में रेज कर दी. तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा बेनिफिट है और ये वन टाइम एक्टिविटी नहीं है. जैसे जैसे आपकी प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी कंपनी की बढ़ती जाती है, वैसे वैसे कंपनी की वैल्यूएशन जो है बढ़ती जाती है. जैसे रिलायंस, रिलायंस अगर आज से 37 साल पहले कंपनी लिस्ट हुई थी रिलायंस, उस समय उस कंपनी की मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन 11 करोड़ थी. रिलायंस की कंपनी 37 साल पहले अपने यहाँ पर लिस्टेड भी थी BSE में, और उसकी मार्केट कैप 11 करोड़ थी. आज रिलायंस की मार्केट कैप 6.5 लाख करोड़ है. विप्रो जिस टाइम में लिस्टिंग हुई थी, उसकी मार्केट कैप 50 करोड़ थी. आज उसकी मार्केट कैप 3 लाख करोड़ है. तो इस तरह से आपकी अगर वैल्यू अनलॉकिंग करनी है कंपनी में, तो इससे अच्छा रास्ता नहीं है, और इससे अच्छा फंड रेजिंग करने का भी रास्ता नहीं है. अगर पैसे आपको लेने हैं मार्केट से फॉर योर बिजनेस एक्सपेंशन एक्टिविटी, फॉर योर ब्रांड बिल्डिंग एक्टिविटी, फॉर योर मार्केटिंग एक्टिविटी, फॉर द क्रेडिबिलिटी ऑफ द प्रोमोटर्स, फॉर द विजिबिलिटी ऑफ द कंपनी, देन दिस इज द बेस्ट वे. Many of the times, what we find that when we require funds, we don't get the funds. Or the person who wants to give the funds, he asks for so many collaterals. कि ठीक है भैया, आप अपनी कंपनी की प्लांट मशीनरी दे दो, आप कोई चीज़ ऐसी गिरवी हमारे पास रख दो जिससे मैं शिफ्ट हूँ। अब ये जो इक्विटी है, एक बार आपकी कंपनी लिस्टिंग हो गई, आपको कोई भी चीज़ गिरवी नहीं रखनी पड़ती है। आपकी जो इक्विटी लिस्टिंग है वो इक्विटी ही आप उनको दे करके उसके सामने यू कैन रेज द फंड्स। सो दिस कैन एक्ट एज ए कोलेटरल फॉर योर कंपनी। जो बहुत बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है कि वो है कि आपकी इक्विटी एक करेंसी बन जाती है, क्योंकि वो ट्रेडेबल होती है मार्केट में। अभी करेंसी दो ही आदमी इशू कर सकता है, एक आरबीआई गवर्नर। हम अगर आपको 2000 रुपये का नोट देते हैं तो आप इसलिए एक्सेप्ट करते हैं क्योंकि आरबीआई उसमें लिखता है आई प्रॉमिस टू पे द बियरर 2000 रुपीज। सो ही कैन इशू करेंसी। द अनदर पर्सन हु कैन इशू करेंसी इज द प्रोमोटर ऑफ द कंपनी। नाउ व्हाट इज रुपी? रुपी इज द इक्विटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। अगर इकोनॉमी आपकी स्ट्रांग होती है देन रुपी एप्रिसिएट्स, इफ द इकोनॉमी फॉल्स देन द रुपी डेप्रिसिएट्स। ओके, सो रुपी इज नथिंग बट द इक्विटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। द अनदर पर्सन हु कैन इशू द करेंसी इज द प्रोमोटर ऑफ द कंपनी, बट द प्रोमोटर ऑफ द कंपनी एंड ही इज ऑल्सो इशूइंग इक्विटी। पेपर ही इशू कर रहा है एंड अगेंस्ट दैट ही इज आस्किंग फॉर मनी। सो ही इज ऑल्सो इशूइंग द करेंसी बट ही मेन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स ही इज वेरी मच स्ट्रॉन्गर देन द आरबीआई गवर्नर बिकॉज he never promised to pay the bearer the price at which he is issuing the shares. Okay, so say for example you have issued, the promoter issued the shares at 100 rupees. Okay, the investors take the shares but the promoter never promised to the investor that he is ready to pay 100 rupees. If he is doing well, the 100 rupees can go to 500 rupees, the investors will make money. But investors are in many pockets and they hold a small chunk of shares, but the major beneficiary is the promoter of the company because he is holding 75% of the shares. So if the prices moves up, he is the biggest beneficiary. If the prices comes down, then he didn't have the liability. So by issuing the equity, the promoter is doing good to his company and to himself, that without taking any liability he is raising funds. So most of the times, being the regulator, we always say that equity is the safest instrument in the hands of the promoter and riskiest instrument in the hands of the investors. So we have to safeguard the interest of the investor. We have to ensure that if the promoter is coming, he is coming for the right cause, right intention, not for doing any speculation, using the money for the business move forward so that it can do good for his company, as well as the investors who gets associated with the company should also make wealth, and later on it becomes an incentive in the hands of the investors to invest in the other companies and make them also big and large. If you see the history of the world, all the companies who have become the large corporate or blue chip company, they all are listed companies. You will never see any unlisted company become a large corporate or big corporate. Or it is rare of the rarest situation. All those people who are sitting along with the Prime Minister in the panels or in the events, etc., they are the promoter of the listed company or the owner of the listed company. So listing is the only tool that can make the company big company or large company. So before the launching of the SME platform, we don't have any other platform unless until your company becomes big. You can't get yourself listed. But by launching this SME platform, what we have done, we have given the opportunity to a small and medium entrepreneurs who has got the post-issue paid-up capital of 3 crores in their company, net tangible assets of 3 crores in their company, and net worth of 3 crores in their company. They can get listed onto the SME platform of the stock exchange. So any company which is meeting the criteria, 3 financial criteria, that is 3 crores of post-issue paid-up capital, 3 crores of net worth, and 3 crores of net tangible asset, can get listed onto the BSE-SME platform. We have also ensured that few concepts can be put onto the SME platform, so that once the promoter comes for the with an IPO, his issue should be fully subscribed. The issue should not fail. So we have introduced the concept of 100% underwriting and the concept of market making, so that the price discovery keeps on happening onto the SME platform. So let me tell you, we have launched an SME IPO index in the year 2012, December 2012, with 100 as base. Today it's quoting somewhere around 1900. And it has given a return of 19 times in last 6 years. So that's what has happened onto the SME platform. Most of the companies which have got listed, they have unlocked their value. I still remember in 2014, we got one company listed, I think in the month of January. The turnover of the company was 10 crores and profit was 50 lakh rupees. The market capitalization of that company was 16 crores in 2014, January. Today the company's turnover is 80 crores and net profit is 32 crores. So this way they got transformed. In 4 years, the turnover jumped by 8 times and profit, I think, almost 50 to 60 times the profit had jumped. Around 2 years back, we have got one company listed called KP Energy from Surat. At the time of listing, I think their net profit was somewhere around 4 crores. The merchant banker has got the company listed at 70 rupees. Today the share price is 700 rupees and the profit has jumped from 4 crores to 17 crores. So this way we have seen a lot of companies getting transformed post listing on the SME platform. What we want is that this message should be spread across the country, so that we can bring more and more small and medium entrepreneurs on this SME platform, groom them, do the hand-holding, and take them to the next level. So that is the purpose for which we have launched this SME platform. Yes, to bring the promoters on the SME exchange is really a very difficult task. I have met around 25,000 promoters in last 5-6 years, almost went in more than thousands of seminars, but still able to convert only 300 companies to get listed onto the SME market. So many of the times there is a fear in the minds of these promoters that if you are going for listing, you have to do a lot of compliances or somebody will take over your company. Let me tell you very categorically that there is not much of the compliances post listing. What you have to do is you have to prepare 2 times balance sheet. One is half yearly balance sheet and another is yearly balance sheet. So half yearly balance sheet doesn't need to be audited. Yes, yearly balance sheet needs to be audited. But anyhow, you are auditing your balance sheet every year. So there is not much of the difference because half yearly balance sheet needs not to be audited. And second thing, that you have to file half yearly shareholding pattern. With the GST in place, I don't think where every month you have to prepare all the documents. So these compliances don't mean anything. So this is total myth that post-listing you have to do a lot of compliances. There is not much increase in compliance, little bit one or two small compliances there, and you have to keep one company secretary on the payroll of your company. So this is only the compliance that need to do post-listing. But if you see the benefits post-listing is much more than these compliances. And if you want someone to believe in your company, you have to do little bit compliances. Otherwise, you remain in your own turf and think that, okay, you can make your company big, but it never happens. So you need to use all the tools that are available in the market to get your companies listed and take yourself to the next level. It's a very big opportunity that we have created for the small and medium entrepreneurs so that they can get listed and enjoy these benefits. So all the benefits you are getting under one umbrella. At the same time, we don't want small and medium companies to remain small and medium forever. We have created a process where after 2 years, in case the post issue paid up capital of the company goes beyond 10 crores, then with 2/3 non-promoters approval, the company can migrate themselves to the main board of the stock exchange. So these are the features of SME platform, and it is going on very well. Aslam Bhai, thanks a lot for calling me for this event. We want more and more. Aslam Bhai got listed around 1.5 years back, right? 1 year back. So Aslam Bhai has got his company listed 1 year back. He is doing well, and I am quite sure he must be getting a lot of benefit post-listing. We want many other companies to come onto the SME platform. As the head of this SME exchange, I can only ensure you and assure you that we will give you the hand-holding, we will give you the red carpet welcome, we will ensure that you keep on growing and growing under the regulatory framework of the country and the stock exchange. With these words, thanks a lot. If you have any queries, you can ask me any point of time. Thanks a lot.
Ajay Thakur, thank you for those wonderful words and insight. We are grateful for your time and the effort you have taken to share your thoughts and experience. I would like to call on stage Mr. Aslam Khan, CEO, Octaware Technologies Limited, to present the memento, a token of our appreciation. Anyone has any questions for Mr. Ajay Thakur, please raise your hand. Anyone interested in asking any questions? Mike?
Thank you, Mr. Ajay, for a very nice presentation. How many companies, by the way, have migrated from SME to main?
Almost 46 companies have migrated to the main board.
So out of 346?
Out of 234 companies,
46 have migrated.
46 companies have already migrated to main.
And they are doing well.
Pardon?
The business-wise, their growth is maintained.
Yeah, they have maintained their growth. See, people understand the listing process in a different way. And the value creation. See, as a stock exchange, we are a facilitator. The platform is a facilitator. Even what type of financing that you are getting through either the stock exchange or through the banks, they are a financing mechanism. Okay? And they create a lot of visibility and all other things. But as far as valuation is concerned, it depends on a strong business. If the business is strong, these things will act as a catalyst to further the growth of the company. But in case the company have started, falling, then even the listing will not help.
Sure.
So if the business model is good, if there is a fund requirement which can fuel the growth of the company, the stock exchange will facilitate all those activities. So what we have seen that the most of the companies, even I have given you the examples also, so most of the companies post-listing have grown exponentially.
Okay.
And even after the migration to the main board also, the valuation of the company have grown. So if you see, the fund raise is around 2,000 crore.
Mm-hmm.
But today the market capitalization of 234 companies is almost 25,000 crore. So you can understand how much they have benefited. Yes, 5-10 companies have also not fared well because after post-listing we have seen a lot of competition in that sector and they have been unable to cope up with all those challenges. So yes, few companies have not fared well, but 90% of the companies have given very good performance.
Sure. Looking at the listing, what are the nature of businesses of those companies? It comes from wide spectrum or?
It comes from wide spectrum across the sector. We are sector agnostic,
okay.
But we don't accept NBFC companies. Yes, as of now we are not accepting NBFC companies. But broking companies who are the members of the stock exchange, they also we have put some threshold. Otherwise, it's sector agnostic. The company from any sector can come and they can get themselves listed onto the stock exchange.
Thank you. Thank
so,
you.
As of now, we have representation from 29 sectors.
So,
the companies from 29 sectors have got listed on our exchange. Thank
you. Sir, when will we be able to trade in BSE-SME index, like Nifty?
See, BSE-SME index? No, as of now, that index is not so active. Because if you
but
see...
We will be able to in future. How
in
many
future,
years?
Of course. Once this
because
segment...
in your lecture, you said it has grown 19 times.
Yeah. So that is to show that, okay, this index is performing. Means that it is giving you an input that all the SME companies or most of the SME companies which have got listed on the SME exchange have fared very well. That is, yes, going forward, once we have got 5,000 companies listed onto the SME exchange, of course, we will start the trading of these indexes also.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your time. I am Mihir Parekh. Having 3 crore of those three conditions, maintaining half yearly balance sheet, yearly balance sheet and all. Which all other conditions are there to be listed, like is a private limited firm and other conditions?
See, you can,
for a small medium,
as far as compliances are concerned, I have told you that, see, there are two ways to look into the thing. One thing what I have talked about is the eligibility criteria for getting the company listed. Mm-hmm. So there are three financial criteria. One is 3 crores of paid up, post issue paid up capital, 3 crores of net worth, and 3 crores of net tangible asset. As far as compliances are concerned, it's half yearly compliance. You have to file half yearly balance sheet, which will be unaudited, and yearly audited balance sheet. And besides that, half yearly shareholding pattern that you have to file with the exchange, which will be again supplied by the registrar to the issues. Okay. So that is the only compliance that needs to be done. Besides that, there is no other compliance that needs to be done.
Type of firm is not mandatory.
No. Which firms will get listed? I think you are asking that what type of firm can get listed.
Yeah.
So the company has to get converted into public limited company to get listed. However, pre-listing or pre-signing of the mandate, the company can be either private limited company or partnership company or sole proprietorship company, or even LLP. Another thing is that LLP and partnership company can be converted into public limited company as per the Companies Act, and even the private limited company can be converted into the public limited company.
Okay.
In case of sole proprietorship firm, it can't be converted. So normally what happens, the people form a new company and do the transfer of the business into that company, and then they get that company listed. But in that case, what happens that you don't have the track record, okay, because it's a new company.
Hmm.
So in that case, what we say that your net worth should be minimum 5 crores. So in case your net worth of the company is 5 crores with 3 crores of net tangible asset, then they can get listed onto the SME platform.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Thakur. My name is Nitin Khankar. I'm a CA myself, and I'm a stock market investor. SME exchange is a great initiative, no doubt, for small, medium enterprises to raise funds. But as far as the investors are concerned, you know, the lot size is high, and I would like you to please throw some light on that. And you know, the liquidity would, by default, remain somewhat low because of the lot size, and the bid-ask spread would also remain wide. So a small investor can invest 10,000 rupees in a main board stock. But you can't invest, in a SME stock with just 10,000. So probably the amount is like 1 lakh or you know, whatever it is. So what would the exchange be doing to address that?
I got your point. The main intention of this SME platform was that, again, I have told earlier that equity is the safest instrument in the hands of the promoter and risk instrument in the hands of the investor. Even I have worked for 25 years in the stock exchange, and you also have been investing for 10, 15 years. Investors' mentality, you know, and many of the time the investors don't do a proper research, and they invest in the company at a very higher valuation, and they land up in losing their money. So many of the investors, instead of going directly, they come indirectly through the mutual funds, etc. Now, in the case of SME platform, SMEs have the cycle, and there are a lot of risks associated when you are investing the equity of the company. So the intention of the regulator was that the informed investors who understand the business with a deep pocket should only come and invest in the company and remain for the longer run. So you can say the investors should be like a small angel investors like thing. So that was the intention. At the same time, we don't want this SME platform as a trading platform. We want this SME platform as an investment destination, where the investor remain with the company for 6 months, 1 year, 1.5 years, 2 years, and 3 years. And then they can make good returns. So for example, in five, 6 years, the SME platform has given 19 times return. So there were chances that the first 6 months, it has not given any return. And after that, the return has shooted up. So it should not happen that in 6 months the investors suddenly get irritated and agitated and they start writing the letters or they start selling onto the stocks. So we want the investors having deeper pocket with longer investment horizon with the understanding of the sector should only invest. So that's why we have kept it to the 1 lakh ticket size. And as I have already said that we don't want that investors should start trading every day. It's more from an investment horizon than liquidity. So then trading. So that's why we have kept like it, like that. As far as the concept of the definition of retail investor, now if you see ICDR guidelines, the definition of retail investor is anybody who is investing below 2 lakh is categorized as retail investor. So retail investor, if you go as per that definition, you can still invest in this. But we have intentionally kept it above 1 lakh to ensure that larger investors with deeper pocket, even if they lose in 5, they should gain in 5-6 companies so that they can average it all. That was the main intent.
Thank you. Just one more follow-up question. What is the average institutional holding in the BSE exchange, SME exchange stocks?
So see, it has average. Started happening. Now we are seeing in last 1 year, the QIB has started investing as a small medium company. If you see earlier the investment was coming from HNIs only. Now we have started the shift in that. And now we are seeing that even the in some of the companies, mutual funds have invested. Or in some of the companies, QIB has invested. Or some of the companies, NBFC has invested. So now this process has started. So I think in the times to come, you will see a lot of participation. Because mostly the ticket size of these SME IPOs are in the range of 10 to 20 crores. Now if you see most of the mutual funds, they have prepared a small fund, a small companies fund and mid-cap fund. But again, for them, the small cap companies are those which has got a market capitalization of minimum 100, 200 crores. So it will take some time, but once it starts happening, then they will come and they will start investing on the SME company.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Colonel Bhadoria and I'm a student of MBA Finance from Alana Institute. My question arises from the recent events that we have seen, the methods that are available of raising funds, capital from the banks or NBFCs, and the kind of frauds that are happening. Is there a ground checking mechanism of a company which submitted documents or prospectus to the BSE for SME listing? The ground checking mechanism, whether the company is actually doing the business or the documents are faked, is there some kind of mechanism? Because an investor, he doesn't know, he can't go to Gujarat or any other state to find out whether the company is functioning on the ground or not. So what is the assurance we have from the SEBI or say BSE that the company being listed is an authentic company and doing its business as it promises?
See, there are two ways to look into bank funding and stock market investment. Okay, from day one, stock market investment is subject to risk. We all know how the equity market works. It always said the buyers be aware. Okay, in that way. Now, the informations that are being shared with the banks are one-to-one in nature. Whereas the prospectus that is being filed with the stock exchange are always in the public domain. And in that prospectus, which is 400-page prospectus, in that the promoter has to disclose everything. Even if there is a criminal proceeding, or they have defaulted somewhere, or if there is some problem in the company, okay, they have to disclose everything which remains in the public domain and which the investors can take on the basis of that the prudent decision whether to invest in that company or not. Okay, that's way how the equity market works. In the debt financing, it's always collateral based financing and the bankers take decisions. Okay, still we have taken some precautionary measure. If some small and medium companies comes to us, we again scrutinize the papers. A lot of responsibility is on the merchant bankers. Okay, they are regulated entity. And the third thing that still we ensure that we go to those places from where the companies are working to ensure that it's a genuine company or it's a paper company. And only after ensuring that, we allow those companies to get listed onto the SME exchange. And still, and what was his question was that why we are keeping the ticket size high of 1 lakh? Because we want such type of investors who have the acumen to study the prospectus, which is detailed in nature. You can't hide anything. And after that, they can take decisions. So that's where we have balanced the risk and reward into the SME platform, and at the same time keeping it on public domain so that people can study, and only after that they think of investing onto the SME companies.
Thank you, sir.